Pero before, talaga, sobrang nadidiscriminate yung mga bakla. Kaya so maglakad-lakad ka lang dyan, sisi ko, kabakla, bakla, bakla. Siguro yung tamang paggalang na lang at respeto sa pagiging bakla. Kasi ang mga bakla naman, kahit bakla, kahit saan tayo magpunta, responsable yung mga bakla. Mm-hmm. Siguro yung mga, pagkakaiba siguro ng mga jejemon at mga bekimon, siguro may makikita kang boss ng isang kumpanya o mataas na tao na gumagamit ng charing, ng churva, ng chuva, mm-hmm. na boss. Pero wala kang makikita ang boss ng kumpanya na, yo, foes, good morning, foes, di ba?
But then again, I wanted to ask you this. Obama recently, medyo, para I'll take it to a different mm-hmm. level, but Obama recently signed a law in the United States, signed into law accepting openly gay men in the military, gay men and women in the military. There used to be a culture of talk not, speak not, ask not, but then that's all gone now. But then gays abroad are not really, how do you say it, hindi parlor gays eh, tulad sa atin. Yan ang tanong ko sa'yo, ang pagiging bading ba ay dapat ganitong anyo lang?
Depende yan sa isang bakla. Kasi katulad ng normal na taong pagiging bakla, it goes with your own responsibility. You have to hold yourself responsible with the things that you do, with the things that you say. Like myself, ako yung nagpakalat ng Bekimon, but in formal communication, hindi ko ginagamit yung gay lingo kasi it's not right.
Okay. So you don't, in formal communication, you don't. May ganun kang compartmentalization. Pero bakit, tanong ko sa'yo, no, bakit sa ibang bansa, like or continents like Europe, no? Gays look like men. I mean, in the Philippines, of course, there are...
Maskulado dun sa kanila.
Yeah, but sa kanila, they really look straight. What is it in the Philippine culture, you think, that bring out the feminine in gays like yourself? You are the common... Mm-hmm. My best friend is gay, and he's like you in a way.
I don't know. Siguro, Filipino gays are really attached to their moms or to their sisters.
Very good.
They try to look... like their moms.
Uh-oh.
Siguro yung gusto nilang mukha din silang babae kasi ginagalang nila yung mga babae.
Uh-oh.
Like that. Pero sa akin naman, okay lang yung ganito. Be contented sa ganitong itsura. Pero we can't really blame other gays who do cross-dressing.
Okay. Yeah.
We should respect them.
Okay. But when you say equal rights, do you believe that... I want to ask you, what would equal rights mean to you? Like if a gay cross-dresses in the office? You'd allow that, or that's too much?
That should be allowed.
Siguro. That should be allowed?
That's,
really?
That should be part of equal rights. That dressing is part of self-expression, and everybody deserves to express themselves.
Okay. Now, Richie De Guzman asks, payag ka ba na maalala mo kaya, isa maalala mo kaya ang buhay mo, maging major bongacious itech? Hirap nun na.
About 2 weeks ago, I was already talking to a researcher from Alaala Mo Kaya. I don't know. They already got my story, but I don't know if it will push through or not.
Okay.
Because the my whole life was very dramatic since my childhood hanggang ngayon na lang naging okay.
Really? Mm-hmm. No, we'd have to have another episode for that. I'd want you to guess because we don't have a lot of time, but we can talk about that.
Yeah.
Now, I Am Jovic asks, where do you draw your inspiration?
I draw my inspiration from my mom. She has really worked hard for us, for the whole family.
Yes.
And aside from that, I draw inspiration from my friends and from the people who understand and appreciate what I do.
I just want to ask you, if it's not too much, you know, were you accepted by your father growing up gay, or were you abused?
I'm legally gay. I'm accepted sa family ever since bata pa po.
So what do you think was the hardest experience in your life growing up?
Well, being gay is not really an issue on my end. The issue is growing up different from the others because I grew up with vitiligo.
Yes.
It's very
hard. Let's talk about that. People are asking, bakit ang puti-puti mo dito on Twitter? Talk about that.
When I was younger, I was brown when I was younger.
Uh-oh.
I had this vitiligo when I was 12. I started having white spots.
Uh-oh.
And then the elderly would tell me, ay, an-an lang yan, nagbibimata.
Yeah,
but it started spreading all over my body and it was like, parang iba na po. And then, hanggang tinutukso na ako ng mga kababata ko, ayaw nila akong lapitan because they were thinking it's contagious and whatnot. They call me halimaw, aswang, aso, dalmatian, lahat ng nakakasakit. It was very hard for me to accept that I was not normal. Iba yung itsura ko sa normal na bata, sa panlaki. Hindi issue yung pagiging bakla ko, hindi issue yung pagiging ganito ko. Pero issue yung pagiging iba ko. So I tried to do something that would help me do something better than what other people do. So I studied hard. I worked hard to support my family. So nung naging fair na ako, naging
pumantay
even,
na.
Even out na
yun. When did it even out?
When I was 17.
17.
It took 5 years.
Uh-uh.
For some people, it would take a lifetime for vitiligo to even out.
Yeah.
But in my case, I was really praying hard to God. God, if you really want me to be white, make me white. And then he listened. He's very nice.
All right. Is there maintenance with vitiligo? Do you have to take medication?
Not really. But since I'm very sensitive to sunlight, so I have to wear sunblock whenever I'm going out.
Oh, so you don't tan, definitely. You don't hit the beach.
I just get pink.
You get pink. No, but after the vitiligo experience, when people see you now, what do they ask?
They're like, puti-puti mo naman, nag-gluta ka.
That's what I asked. Yeah. Yes, yes. But do you still feel a bit of insecurity or you've overcome it?
Whenever people would tell, nag-gluta ka naman, puti mo ganyan, I feel happy and contented kasi parang relieved na ako, tapos na ako dun sa stage na nagtatanong ako kung bakit. Kasi ngayon, parang I feel very special.
Well, you know, you have a beautiful smile. You're smiling all the time.
Thank you.
Yeah, is that natural?
Yeah.
Ever since you were a kid, you were just smiling? Okay. All right. Now, I want to ask you, this is a very good question since we don't have a lot of time today. Mm-hmm. But one question is, can you name us your top 10 Bekimon words? Here, somebody asked that. I want to... Mm-hmm. Okay. Top 10 Bekimon words.
Ditraks, ditembang, dito. Itay, itetch.
No, you have to tell us the meaning.
Itay, itetch, that means ito. Bagelia, that means bag. Doonkler, donchi, that means doon. Balaychina, bahay. Ket-ket, bucket, or why. What else?
Kalurki.
Kalurki,
kaloka. That's very yours, yeah.
Nakakalurki. Korekong na may takong, correction na babaeng kriminal hulog sa kanal, patay. Correct. Plang, ganitang butas na kung tawagin ay hula hoop. That means plangak, or yes. Lastly, ano pa ba? Ano pa ba?
Haller is yours.
Haller.
Hiller. Hiller is
yours. Hilochina.
Yes.
Rambutanelio luliwawaw chini cologne, like what I used in the video. Rambutan.
All right, okay. Now give us your last words, Bern. You've been a pleasure this morning.
Yeah, thank you for inviting me first.
Of course.
And for the gay people, just keep on doing what you think is good. So don't stop doing good things, especially to other people. Mm-mm. And keep on doing self-improvement. In that way, we can contribute to the success and the betterment of the world.
No, somebody asked here, pahabol ko na lang, do you have a partner or a boyfriend?
I'm single. I've been single for like 4 or 5 years.
So you date? Do you like to date?
Yeah, I'm open to that.
Okay, how old are you?
I'm 24.
Okay, oh, a bata? 24, oh gosh, all right. Sobra, sorry, there are 50 tweets coming in right now.
Oh,
my apologies,
gosh.
I am so sorry. But we'll have you again. Can we have you again on the show?
Sure,
please,
anytime.
Please. So, Bern, my congratulations. What's your New Year's wish now that you're a star?
Good career, yun lang.
Good career. Mm-hmm. You want to pursue TV?
Of course.
Yeah,
I want to do hosting and acting at the same time.
Well, there's a whole career in hosting. Mm-hmm. I want you to know that.
Thank
you. So I am wishing you the best. And good luck with UKG.
Thank you.
Are you a mainstay permanently?
Yes.
That's good. Congratulations to you.
Thank you.
All right. So, well, I won't be in tomorrow because it's already New Year's Eve. But we will be replaying some of the more interesting interviews. Of course, including Bern Persia of Bekimon. We'll be replaying his interview over and over again on ANC. And that's Head Start for 2010. And you know what? I just want to say this. I've been asked often, what do you think was one of your blessings in 2010? And I have to tell you from the bottom of my heart, joining ANC was one of the best things I've ever done this 2010. Meeting the people in ANC and being in a show like Head Start. I just never thought that it would be this fruitful, this fulfilling, and honestly speaking, I'm the one that has grown on ANC. So I want to thank you for that. I love you all and I'll see you on January 3. So Happy New Year, everyone, and embrace someone today. Ah, diba? My God.